guys, so today I wanted to do a quick little love it or leave it video on the Kaja Roller Glow Highlighter. So I've been using this and I wanted to give it its own little video so you guys can see it and hear its stats. It retails for $28 at Sephora. This is one of their new K-beauty brands and it only comes in one shade right now, which is number one, Cosmic Laundry. And the packaging is magnetic. And then there's a little door, which definitely has a little gold bar sheen. And then there's a spot for your roller to fit into the packaging. It also comes with an additional roller in the box, so you can throw this one away when you feel like it's getting unhygienic and then use this one. Of course, you don't have to use the roller, but that is part of kind of the gimmick and the product. You could always use your regular sponge and your fingers and such if you don't feel comfortable with this. This shade is described as a pink pearlescent glow with a golden undertone. I've used this twice before, but I wanted to show you guys how it looks over a matte foundation too. So we're gonna just roll back and forth like this. I put a decent amount of pressure. Sometimes I roll up, sometimes I roll this way, and just with a little light pressure so I don't cover the whole cheekbone, just using the corner. And you can see it definitely has a glow to it. You can see the pink reflex. I think it applies beautifully over lots of things, whether it's matte or dewy. And that's what I kind of like about it. It's kind of foolproof. And it does give you a wet look. And it, to me, it's pretty booming for a wet look, but you don't get a super large amount of pigment. It's more of that pink reflect before and after. You can definitely see a difference. Let's do the other side. A little tap, tap, tap on the edges close to my eye because I don't want to have to roll too close to there. To me, it does a really good job because I tend to struggle with cream highlights sometimes, or just cream anything, like, you know, blushes and stuff like that, just because sometimes it breaks up what I got going on. It's a really, you know, important area between that concealer and that contour. So a few dabs and a few light-handed rolls for the most part look pretty good. The roller is not super plush or like fluffy. It's just, it has the same consistency of the powder puffs that you see in most like drugstore powders, or just powders in general. It's not like fuzzy. So I'll even take it on the bridge of my nose because it just sits perfectly right here and it gives me that little flush. So this isn't gonna give you, like I said, a lot of pigment, but for what it is and how well I think it applies, and I've used it a couple times, I don't see any sort of huge indentation, so it doesn't seem like it's taking too much product. I would definitely buy other shades if they did come out with other shades. And yes, you can lock the roller on, by the way, but the door doesn't actually like fully lock, or maybe it's just mine, but for the most part it's just pressure closed. I haven't tried anything else from their brand. They do have other things, and they have some things that are called like mochi this, bento this. It's definitely a cutesy food theme, or kind of, you know, it's generally cutesy packaging. So if you guys want to see me check out like their concealers and their other products, give this video a thumbs up and let me know if you would use a roller highlighter. I know it's kind of gimmicky and different, but to me it performs if you like a wet look, and I do. I do. Thank you guys as always for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick love it or leave it. If you want to check out my other love it or leave it, I will link off a few right here, and my love it or leave it playlist down below, which kind of consists of just short dedicated reviews on one or two products. With all that being said, thank you guys again. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new here, and I will see you guys in a later video.